The video you're currently watching is a phone camera that was brought into the vMix software and also to the OBS software using a 20-meter USB cable. Now, I tested this both on the vMix and the OBS and it worked perfectly fine. This was a setup I recently did for a church, and here's the broadcast we did with this connection.
It's been stopping. If it was my start, if it was the reputation, if it was finances, if it was a relationship, let it be recovered now, in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus.
You can see how smooth and fine it is, and both the audio and the video syncs in together. Now, everything from how we're able to get the cable, run the connection, do all the settings is what I'm going to be sharing with you in today's video. Don't also forget, it's going to be a long ride. Smash that red subscribe button below if you haven't, and also turn on the notification bell. Let's dive into the tutorial. The first thing that you need is a sound card. Over here, I'm using the Behringer sound card. Now, you can use a Focusrite or any other sound card. This will enable you to get a clear audio and also to connect your audio from the mixer down to the system. And I'll also show you in the course of the video how you can sync it with the video that is coming in from your phone camera. Now, over here, we have the 24-channel mixer. Just get the cable running from your mixer down to the sound card. Also speak to your sound engineer to run the cable for you, so they enable you to connect the mixer down to the sound card, and from the sound card could just connect the USB there that goes in to the system, and that is what you need as your first step. Second thing that you need is a 20 meter USB male to female. Now, it can be 30 meters, it can be 40 meters, it can be 50 meters, depending on the distance from where you want to mount your phone camera to the media room. And that will determine if you're going to get 10 meters or 20 meters. So just measure the distance and know the amount you are getting. Over here, I'm using the 20 meters male to female, very important. And you could see the picture right there on the screen. If you stay in Africa, you could also send me a message on WhatsApp. I'll drop my WhatsApp number in the description of this video, and we'll ship worldwide. Could also send it to you wherever you are in Africa. If you stay outside of Africa, you could also use this picture here to search for it on your local store, depending on the country where you are. Open your phone and let's configure it. Go over to the settings on your phone. That's from here. Now, once the setting is up already, scroll down till you see about phone. Click on the about phone, go over to the software information, click on that on your own smartphone. Now click on this build number. What you're looking for is just the build number. Okay, so double tap on the build number 4 times, 1, 2, 3, 4. It will ask you to put in your password, and once you've already done that, the developer option will be turned on. And let's go back to the developer option, go back. Over here on the settings, scroll down, you're going to see the developer option here. Click on the developer option. And once you've already clicked on it, scroll down till you see USB debugging. Very important, turn this on. Okay, so this will enable the Aerial webcam and other apps that you're going to be using to work properly well. Head over to Play Store and download the Aerial webcam. The right one here that you're going to install, Aerial 4K webcam for PC and mobile. That is the one you're going to install on your phone. And let me show you how you can be able to link it up with the 20 meter USB cable. This is the male part of the USB cable, and then this also is the female part of the USB cable. Now, the male part goes in to your PC, and the female part is where you plug in your phone charger. Taking the male part, plug it into your system, and also taking the female part, plug your phone charger into it. As you can see on the screen, the power is showing red, and that is because the other end, which is a Type-C or whichever charger you're using, have not gone into the phone. Now, if it goes into the phone, you're going to see the green pop-up also right there on the screen, as you can see. Once you plug in the other end of your charger into your phone, open the Aerial webcam. As you can see on the screen, because the USB debugging is already enabled, this is what you're going to see on the screen. And make sure the male part is plugged in on your system, and this is how it's going to look like on your own phone. It's successfully connected. Now we're going to turn off the mic icon because we are not using the phone microphone. We're using the sound card which you saw earlier, and we don't want the Aerial webcam to send in both the audio from the phone using the phone microphone down to the system. I wouldn't want that. I want to use the sound card there on the screen. For you to know when the connection is successful or not, make sure that this green thing here is showing on the screen. If it's not showing, if it's only showing the red, it means that it's not successfully connected. And once the green one is also showing there on the screen, it means that the connection is successful and it should be able to see the signal from the phone down to the system. And this is the phone here mounted on the tripod. This is one of the USB, the male part of the USB cable. It goes directly to the system, and please don't plug it on USB hub, because if you do, it will not work. So it goes directly to the USB port on your system. Very important, don't plug it on any USB port. It goes direct to the USB port on your system. And this also is the second USB cable of the 20 meters. The male part, it goes in directly to the USB port on your system and not a USB hub. And do it like this and it will work perfectly fine. And once you've already done this, you have your sound card there. Let's go ahead and open the Erion webcam. Everything connected, let's open the Erion webcam and let me show you. And this is the Erion webcam, is up already, and you can see the signal there, the first camera and also the second camera. I see the both of them are connected together, and you can see the quality right there on the screen. And I'm also going to share with you again the broadcast that we did with it. I showed you earlier the broadcast that we did with these connections, which I'm also going to play out before the end of this video, so you could also see it as well. The Erion webcam minimized, let's go ahead and open the vMix software, and let me show you how you can be able to pop all this up on the vMix software before we go over to the OBS connections. It's still the same thing that we're doing on the vMix, the same thing that you also do on the OBS. Now once your vMix is up, click on the add button there on the screen, go over to camera, and then when you go over to the cameras, the one you're going to select, you're going to see Erion webcam #2, #3, #4, and the one that doesn't have the hashtag is the Erion webcam 1. Now click on that one, which is the Erion webcam 1, and select that particular one. Now also on the resolution, you can scale it up to what you want. You can use the 1920 by 1080, and the frame rate you could keep it at 30 fps. That is perfectly fine. The audio device, you already selected the Erion microphone there for me, but we're not going to use that. We're going to use a sound card. I'm going to select the USB audio codec there, and that is the sound card that we have there on the screen. And once you're done, click on OK. And this is how it's going to look like. Now the video is coming in, the audio is coming in, the both of them are synced in together. And let's go over and bring in the second camera. Click on the add button again, go over to your cameras, select your cameras, and then this time around we are going to use the Erion webcam #2, and that is the second camera that we have there. Click on that, and once you've done that, go over to the frame rate and use the 29 or the 30 fps. Click on the audio device and remove it from, make sure it's not on the Erion. Select the sound card that you have there on the screen, and also click on OK. And this is the two of them connected together side by side. And this is how to run this connection using a USB 20 meter cable or 30 meter cable, depending on whichever one you want to use. Now it's very, very highly recommended that you use a USB 3.0. please do not buy a USB 2.0. you can message me, my number is in the description of this video, and we'll ship worldwide, could send it across to you the exact cable that we use for this connection. And you can see the movement right there on the screen, and this is what they are still using up to this moment. If you also want to run this connection on OBS, all you have to do is just bring in your Erion webcam on the OBS software, just like I did on the vMix, and you are good to go. And this is how to run this. If you also want to use your iPhone for it, you could also use your iPhone for it. The USB 20 meter cable will work perfectly fine with your iPhone. Erion webcam is available for iPhone as well. Go ahead and install it, and that is what we are also using here. So it's available for both iPhone users and the Android users, and it's still the same process. Just plug in your iPhone charger to your phone and then to the female part on the USB cable, and you are good to go. That way you can use your iPhone, you can use your Android, whichever one you want to use. And thank you very much for watching. Remember to hit that subscribe button below, and also subscribe to the channel. Support me. God bless you, and see you on the next one.